ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕਾ ਖਾਲਸਾ, ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਕੀ ਫਤਿਹ। ਹੁਕਮਨਾਮਾ ਟੁਡੇ ਇਜ਼ ਔਨ ਅੰਗ 807 ਆਫ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਗ੍ਰੰਥ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਬਾਏ ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਅਰਜਨ ਦੇਵ ਜੀ। ਸਤਨਾਮ ਸ੍ਰੀ ਵਾਹਿਗੁਰੂ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ। ਬਿਲਾਵਲ ਮਹੱਲਾ ਪੰਜਵਾ। ਸਹਜ ਸਮਾਤ ਅਨੰਦ ਸੁਖ, ਪੂਰੇ ਗੋਰੇ ਦੀਨ, ਸਦਾ ਸਹਾਇ ਸੰਗ ਪ੍ਰਭ ਅੰਮ੍ਰਿਤ ਗੁਣ ਚੀਨ। ਸਹਜ ਸਮਾਤ ਅਨੰਦ ਸੁਖ, ਪੂਰੇ ਗੁਰੇ ਦੀਨ, ਸਦਾ ਸਹਾਇ ਸੰਗ ਪ੍ਰਭ ਅੰਮ੍ਰਿਤ ਗੁਣ ਚੀਨ। ਜੈ ਜੈਕਾਰ ਜਗਤ੍ਰ ਮਹ ਲੋਚ ਹੈ ਸਭ ਜੀਆ, ਸੁਪ੍ਰਸੰਨ ਭੈ ਸਤਗੁਰ ਪ੍ਰਭੂ ਕਛ ਬਿਕਨ ਨਾ ਥੀਆ। ਜਾ ਕਾ ਅੰਗੋ ਦਇਆਲ ਪ੍ਰਭ ਤਾਕੇ ਸਭ ਦਾਸ, ਸਦਾ ਸਦਾ ਵਡਿਆਈਆ ਨਾਨਕ ਗੁਰ ਪਾਸ। ਜਾ ਕਾ ਅੰਗੋ ਦਇਆਲ ਪ੍ਰਭ ਤਾਕੇ ਸਭ ਦਾਸ, ਸਦਾ ਸਦਾ ਵਡਿਆਈਆ ਨਾਨਕ ਗੁਰ ਪਾਸ। ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਅਰਜਨ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਬਲੈਸਿੰਗ ਅਸ ਬਿਲਾਵਲ ਰਾਗ, ਰਾਗ ਫੁੱਲ ਆਫ ਹੈਪੀਨੈਸ। ਸਤਿਗੁਰੂ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਗੁਰੂ ਮਹਾਰਾਜ ਜੀ ਬਿਗਿਨਸ ਦ ਸ਼ਬਦ ਸਹਜ ਸਮਾਤ ਅਨੰਦ ਸੁਖ ਪੂਰੇ ਗੁਰਦੀਨ। ਨਾਓ ਦ ਵਰਲਡ ਟਾਕਸ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਮੈਡੀਟੇਸ਼ਨ, ਦ ਵਰਲਡ ਟਾਕਸ ਅਬਾਊਟ Samaadhi, about this state of meditation where one is totally absorbed into meditation. But some people say focus upon the sun, some people say focus upon candles, some people focus upon this and that. But Guru Sahib Ji says, the Pura Guru, the perfect blessed Guru, he has deen, he has blessed me with a Samaadhi of Sahaj, of complete peace, balance and poise. And this Samaadhi is not a flickering sense of happiness. When Guru Sahib Ji blesses a Sikh with Sahaja Samad, it doesn't matter whether that Sikh is cut into bits or whether he is burnt alive. It doesn't matter what happens to that Sikh, that Sahaja Samaadhi cannot be broken, because it is focused on that Vaheguru who is pervading through all, on that Lord who is pervading through all. So that Sahaja Samad, that true eternal state of peace and focus and concentration, is full of Anand. Anand, that happiness which never ends, eternal happiness. That's what Anand is. An eternal Sukh, eternal glee, eternal joy, a never-ending state of bliss. That is what the Guru is talking about. That is what Guru Sahib Ji is saying to us today. Not a flickering sense of pleasure, but an all-enduring, eternal sense of bliss. That is the Sahaj Samad. Sada Sahai Sang Prab Amrit Gun Cheen. And those Gurmukh Pyare who are coloured in this Sahaj Samad, in this Samadhi of Sahaj, of complete spiritual peace and poise, eternal peace, what is their avastha like? What is their state of being like? And Guru Sahib Ji says, Sada Sahai Sangha Prabhu. They realise that that Prabhu, that Waheguru, is Sada Sahai, is always with them. And Sangha, he is always with them wherever they go. As Guru Arjan Dev Ji says in Asarag, Gur Mere Sang Sada Hai Nale. The Guru, Waheguru, Akal Purakh, the Lord, is always with me wherever I go. There's no place I can go where the Guru isn't sung, the Guru isn't with me. So, Guruji says, Rahal, pause and think about this. This is the crux of the Shabad. This is the center of the Shabad. And Guruji goes on to tell us, Jaya Jaya Kar Jagatra Mah Lochaha Sab Jiya. That Gurmukha Pyara, that beloved soul, who's blessed with Sahaj Samadhi, wherever they go, there is Jaya Jaya Kar, there are triumphant cheers. Jaya Jaya Kar meaning, people, like in English, would say, all hail. Wherever that Gurmukha Pyara goes, wherever that soul goes, that blessed soul who's merged into Vaheguru, all of the beings bow down to that soul. Locha hai sab jiya. And all jiya, all the creatures, all the beings, locha hai, yearn to have that state of Sahaj Samadhi. Even we don't know, we feel that we are sometimes incomplete. We feel this void in our lives. Some people try and fill this void with drugs. Some people try and fill this void with lust and desire. Some people try and fill this void with greed. Some people try and fill this void with money and material goods. But Guruji says this void can only be filled by Sahaj Samadhi, by true celestial state of peace, that true spiritual state of being, which is blessed by the true Guru. There's no other way. When the true Prabhu, when Vaheguruji and the Sadguru, the true Guru, were pleased with me, Suprasan means to be pleased, when they were totally pleased, completely pleased, got bigger than Ati, had no bigger, no obstacle blocked my path. Nothing blocked my way. Jaka Angu Dayal Prabhu. That person who with them, Angasang, completely with them on all times, has that Dayal, has that merciful Lord, Vaheguru, that Prabhu. Ang in this case means that person who has enshrined God within them, who is completely one with Akal Purakh and has that complete faith in Vaheguruji. That is what is called Ang in this part of the Shabad. Just as Bhagat Ravidas ji says in Sri Rag on Ang 93 of Sri Guru Granth Sahib ji, Tohi Mohi Mohi Tohi Antar Kaisa. Between you and me and you are Vaheguruji, there is no difference. What is the difference? Because that person whose ego has dissolved and has completely been enveloped by the Lord has Vaheguruji on their side at all times, all times. So Satguru Sahib Ji says, Jaka Anga Dayal Prabhata Ke Sab Das. Everyone becomes his Das. Everyone becomes that person's servant who is living their life in the command of Vaheguru, in the hukam of Vaheguru, and in that Sahaj Samadhi, in that celestial state, in that spiritual state of complete internal bliss. Even the elements, even nature, everything comes under the control of that Gurmukh Pyara, and everybody endeavors to serve him. Just like when Bhagat Kabir Sahib Ji was arrested by the Mughal rulers of his time, and Bhagat Ji was thrown in front of an elephant, And Bhagatji has told us about this in Gurbani. In Rag Gond, on Ang 870, of Guru Granth Sahib Ji, Bhagat Kabir Ji tells us what happens. Puja band pila kar daryo. Bhagat Ji says they bundled, tied me into a bundle and threw me in front of the elephant. Hasti krop mund meh maryo. The man who was maneuvering the elephant hit the elephant in the head and ordered him to crush Bhagat Kabir Ji. Hast bhag kai chisa mara. But the elephant backed away and chisa mara and cried out, Ya murd kai ho balihare. And Bhagat Ji tells us that what this elephant said, the elephant when he was crying out was saying, I'm balihare, I'm a sacrifice to this soul. And Bhagat Kabir Ji tells us this beautiful story of what happened. Ahe mere thakur tumra jor, oh my Waheguru, you are my only strength, Bhagat Kabir Ji says. Kaji bakbo hasti tor, and the Kaji, the judge, keeps shouting, oh, make this elephant move on to the driver. Re muhavad tuj darao kaat. The judge cries out and says, oh, driver of the elephant, oh, maneuver of the elephant, I will cut you into pieces if you don't get this elephant to kill Bhagat Kabir Sahib Ji. Isahatrav ho kal ho saat. Hit the elephant and make him drive. Make him go forward. Hastana tore, but the elephant didn't move. Taradyan. It meditated. It concentrated. Vaka hriday basai bhagwan. Waheguru Ji lives even within that elephant. Within that elephant. Kya aparad santa hai kina? What aparad? What sin can this saint have done? Bandh port kunchar ko dina, that you have thrown him before the elephant. Kunchar port la namsakara. And the elephant took the bundle of Bhagat Kabir Ji in its trunk and bowed down to Bhagat Kabir Ji again and again. But Bhagat Ji says, Bujja nahi kaji andhyara. The Kaji, who was blind by darkness, couldn't understand this. So, what does this mean? Where does this fit into the Shabad? The idea is, Jaka Ang Dayal Prabhata Ke Sabdas, that person who has Waheguru Ji with them, Ang Sang, at all times. Ang Sang meaning with them at all times, realizes that Waheguru Ji is there and protector at all times. Taha Ke Sabdas, even the animals, even nature, becomes their servants, like that elephant that bowed down to Bhagat Kabir Ji. Sada sada vadiyaya, vadiyaya, glory and greatness that will remain sada sada forever and forever, till the end of time, eternal greatness, Nanak Guru Pas. Guru Sahib Ji says, eternal greatness is only found Pas with the Guru, nowhere else in this world. We may look to this world to try and fulfill us, but it cannot be done. Only the true Guru can bless us and fulfill that yearning which is inside all of us to be whole, to be complete. Jaka Ango Dayal Prabhu Taki Sabdas Sada Sada Vadiyaya Nanak Gur Paas. Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh.